As you learn about the narcissistic pattern, it's also wise to reflect on the much healthier alternatives. Now below, you're going to find a link to my new extensive course called Ready, Set, Connect. It addresses both the mindset and the skills involved in gratifying relationships, and I hope you'll find it to be quite therapeutic. Things that happens after you've been exposed to strongly narcissistic individuals is you find that you lose a lot of the best ingredients of yourself, and you wind up playing into the games that narcissists throw at you. Keep in mind that they're pathologically selfish individuals, but they're also individuals who are afraid of examining themselves. So what they do in their selfishness and their need for control is they have all sorts of strategies, if you will, to try to bring out the worst in you. And then without any particular self-examination, they'll say, well, since you've got some negative things going on here, that must mean that I'm the standard bearer. And so they actually take delight when they can bring you down and get you into all sorts of negative reactions. Now, I want you to think, how many times have you thought, yeah, being with these narcissistic individuals, I find myself disliking what's going on inside of me. Something needs to change. What I want to do here today is I want to focus on 10 of the worst responses that you can offer when a narcissist comes at you with their control and domination games. And then we're going to take a look at where we can go instead. So let me run through these, and I want you to take some real good notes and inventory about where this might impact you. Number one, when we talk about poor responses that you have to the narcissist, one of the first ones I'm going to say is there are times when you've just decided, I'm just going to suppress my emotions. I'm going to suppress my initiatives. I don't want to poke the bear. And you find yourself being way too calculated in the way that you engage. It's like, well, I have to appease, or I just can't let myself be known because it's going to bring nothing but trouble. Number two, you get sucked into predictably ineffective arguing. How many times have you thought, I had this bad exchange with this person, we wound up getting into an argument, and it didn't work again? And yet, there are times when the narcissist can be so outrageous in their accusations and blaming towards you that sometimes you just can't refrain, and so you get pulled right in. Number three, you respond to a narcissist's stubbornness and controlling attitude with your own stubborn and controlling reactions. They come at you with the idea that says, let me tell you how things are going to be, and then you can come right back and say, no, let me tell you, and before you know it, you're exchanging insult for insult, and you're allowing yourself to match pitch with the very person that you don't want to match pitch with. How does that work out? It doesn't. They're not going to change, that's for sure. And it brings out that ingredient in you that's not going to help you. Number four, and that is, you can plead way too much for the narcissist to adjust, or you can plead for them to understand. Come on, you need to understand this, and I told you this. Why can't you go along with me? And I want you to think, well, how many times does that work for you? And again, it doesn't, but it brings out the worst in you. Number five, you find it difficult to get beyond the simmering anger and disgust that is generated with that narcissist. Too many times I've had people that would come into my counseling office and they would just say, I go into this muttering or agitation or annoyance, and that's not me, when in fact, actually, that is you. It's just a side of you don't want to see. And before you know it, they can create such an undertow of irritability that becomes far too common of a defining feature for you. Number six, and that is, sometimes you can be compelled to justify or explain yourself far too strongly when you've been accused. And I want you to think, when you do, I mean, the narcissist, of course, is going to blame you. It's their way of trying to get the focus off themselves. When you justify and when you explain, how many times does that narcissist come back and say, oh, well, that's really enlightening. Thank you so much for sharing that perspective. they don't do it, and you wind up being in the ditch with all of your frustration that goes along with that. Number seven, one of the worst things that you can do is you respond to the narcissist, and that is you dread being totally honest. You think to yourself, well, I know that if I start talking about who I really am and what I really feel, it's not going to end well. Now, sure enough, I do think that there's a certain amount of discernment that you want to use as you confront or talk or expose who you are. But when you find yourself thinking, I can't really explain who I am and what I feel and all like that, I just have to keep all that covered up, that's a sign that it's a very unhealthy relationship, which then leads to number eight. And that is one of the worst ways that you can respond to a narcissist is you become a person who goes in hiding. You keep secrets. You become evasive. You wind up saying things that are inaccurate. Or number nine, you can engage in your own self-sabotaging rebellion. There are so many times when people have had the negatives with the narcissist that behind the scenes, they start doing things and getting involved in activities or with individuals that are not good for them. It's like at some point you decide, I don't even care anymore because my life is just a wreck anyway. And then number 10, you can feel embarrassed when people learn what's really happening in your personal life. It's like, oh, I dread people knowing who I am, and you feel like you have to apologize too much, and you wind up being so image conscious that you just find yourself going into that, going behind your shield way too much. Now, it's very important for you to see these signs that I'm mentioning here, the worst responses that you can have to a narcissist's games, not to create shame in you, because that's not our purpose, but to just create a sense of reality thinking, you know, this is not working. And the bottom line is I'm allowing that narcissist to set my pace, and they're wielding way too much power and way too much influence in my life. I can do better. I can be better. Now, having said that, let's take a look at some alternative thoughts and insights that can guide you as you get away from these mistakes that I have just mentioned to you. The first thing I want you to remind yourself of is you are meant to be loved. I'm hoping that you can realize I want to love other individuals and I want to be loved, but unfortunately, the narcissist is not going to be the one who's going to be able to share that with you. Narcissism, in my opinion, can be defined by the absence of love. A second thing that I'm hoping you can hold on to, and that is you've been judged way too many times, and what's worse, we're going to say that narcissist is not qualified to be your judge. So when they come along and say, well, you're stupid, or you're no good, or you don't know what you're talking about, it's like, well, consider the source. I'm not going to allow myself to think, well, since this person's saying it, I've got to correct it. No, you don't. They're not qualified. Now, another thing I'm hoping you can hold on to, and that is actually when you respond to narcissists with all of your frustration, there are plenty of times when your anger makes sense, but let's keep in mind that anger that can actually have a valid foundation to it gets lost, or the decency of it gets lost, when you go into a mean place with it. And so you want to understand what healthy, assertive anger is and stand in that and know that you can hold firmly to who you are and what you believe, and you can act upon your own separate initiatives. And let's also keep in mind the narcissist loves to feed off of your dysregulation. They need you to be dysregulated, and we're going to just basically say to that, well, you're not under any obligation to give them what feeds them. We're not going to do that. They're threatened by your distinctions, but you know what? That's not your problem to solve. Self-restraint is your friend. But like I say, it doesn't mean that you hold back and you're not going to be the initiative. You can still have your own independence. You can still have your own unique initiatives. But ultimately, your calm resolve is going to be your superpower. You can refuse to be pulled in by the woman whose desire is to keep you disrupted. Narcissists are not mature people. They have little wisdom to draw upon. Therefore, I'm hoping you can decide, I'm not going to be in this reactor mode where I find myself playing off of them. And even if the narcissist doesn't like you when you're in your independent frame of mind, you know what? That's the only way I have to go if I'm going to be a healthy individual. The bottom line is, it's not enough for you to say, I just don't like the way they treat me. You become most effective in your own personal life when you realize I'm not going to try to reform the narcissist. I don't have to be chronically in reaction to them. Being me is sufficient. And what that means is I'm going to see what's good inside of me, and I'm going to live into that, and I'm going to work on my best ingredients between now and the end of my days. That's what I'm going to do. So I'm hoping you can be honest with yourself, because that's such an essential ingredient in your growth and breaking away from some of the bonds that you have with these individuals. But then that honesty is going to be a springboard towards healthy initiatives and a healthier way of responding. And that way you can claim the best there is to claim in you. That's when you know that you've broken away and you're truly on your way towards a good way of life that's anchored in dignity, respect, and civility, which is what we stand for here on Team Healthy. And I hope this gives you some good awareness of what you might need to watch for. If you've not already hit that subscribe button, I would encourage you to do so, and we're going to keep more videos coming your direction. I truly appreciate you allowing me to be on your path with you. There are times when you're looking at things like this when you think, you know, I could use some therapy. And obviously I'm a therapist, but I'm retired from my counseling practice. But it's something obviously I believe in. It's so helpful when you can sit down and talk about what your issues are, and that person, that therapist can have an arm of encouragement around you, so to speak, and can help you find insights and awareness so that you can be on your path towards self-discovery. We have a link to the people at betterhelp.com. It's an online therapy resource. I've been sponsored by them for years. Please, as the need is there, go through the link and get the help that you need. Also, I've put together some courses, and these are very extensive. They're teaching classes, if you will, and they take quite a bit of effort for you to go through, but it can be worth it. Each course has at least 25 videos with written handouts that go along with each video, along with guided questions. We have Ready, Set, Connect about making healthy connections. This Is Me about establishing your boundaries, free to be, finding yourself despite the controllers. We also have my website that has plenty of articles and access to my webinars, which are 90-minute presentations, very different from my courses, along with access to the podcast and my books, plenty of other resources. Okay, narcissists want to keep you discombobulated. They want to keep you in an irregular frame of mind, and what you don't want to do is play along with that. I'm hoping you can see, yeah, there are some options that I have that are not going to be good. But then knowing that those are options, you can set those aside and say, but I'm going to go with the better options. I truly want you to be a person that says, I'm committed to my own mental health, and I'm going to zero in on what that requires. And if the narcissist says, I don't agree with you, chances are you're probably doing something right at that point. That being the case, I'm hoping you can commit yourself to something right and good, and it can eventually take you into your place of sustained peace.